This ominous prospect acts as a natural trigger for Kim's first incarnated apprehension of the innate separateness of all human beings from one another. What unbridgeable separateness it is, too, involving such unmerciful magnitudes of distance. Even when in company with one another, it seems every incarnated human is just as alone as that far future astronaut who will fly back home at such warp speed that they'll find the Earth has aged a million years during the course of their own mere few years flying, returned now to a planet where only they themselves must remain alone until their death. But that's just the standard issue sadness of distance. Whereas Dud's and Ashley's attack incorporates a still greater assault, he feels. It seems they want to morph Kim into a form where he's no longer inclined to take account of the suffering caused in people by their incarnations. People would be more than they are, Kim can see, if they weren't so powerfully targeted by the likes of Ashley and Dud and Bangdead and their soul-dead trivia. Then how much more would people be inclined to think and to look into others around them, searching not for their own littleness, but for what to build, onwards and upwards together. For how many of the most beautiful feelings in the world are born only to be crushed, frustrated, overridden by lesser feelings, lesser forces? How huge a proportion of the world's population is hungry, and how many more in misery? The vulnerability and frequent defeat of the finest feelings and achievements, the fact that finer aspirations are so regularly broken, that such breakage passes so often unnoticed, and that this unnoticing prevails unpunished, these are perpetual tragedies.